at 5 months old, I was adopted. My birth mom actually was in Teen Challenge when she made the decision to put me up for adoption. The family that adopted me was awesome. I grew up going to church Tuesday nights, Wednesday nights, Sunday mornings, Sunday nights. I was always at church. And so I remember being 16 years old in youth group and knowing that God had a calling on my life. But I struggled with so many insecurities and issues of abandonment and rejection. And I found myself choosing a lifestyle of being promiscuous, getting hooked onto drugs and drinking and partying and just trying to find fulfillment in anything but God. And at 18, I got court ordered to Teen Challenge. I went through, finished the whole program, graduated. But I didn't really surrender everything to God. I thought Jesus was cool, but so were a lot of these other compromises in my life. And so before I knew it, I was back at where I was. I didn't think that things could get worse, but they did. I was with this girl, and she had just turned 21. So the night before, I had this brilliant idea. I thought that I was gonna rob an Oxy dealer for a prescription and gift it to her for her birthday. It just went all wrong. I didn't know that he had a bunch of guys with him. And so I got the windows of my car just smashed, the side panels of my car destroyed. I took off running, barely making it out of that situation, being chased what seemed like forever. It was only a couple days after I'm driving to go pick up heroin from another drug dealer, and I was running late. And so at this point, I'm speeding. I'm going like 80 plus miles an hour. I looked away for a second. When I look back, there's brake lights to a big rig. I swerve, hit one car, smash into the semi, then go right into the center divider. I miraculously like walked out of that car accident like untouched. I should have been dead. I broke both the axles of my car. It smashed. My mom's telling me, God's trying to get a hold of your life, son, what are you doing? And I just kept running harder. A friend that I grew up in youth ministry with, grew up in church with, he was buying heroin from me, and it was a Sunday night, and I sold him, a half gram of heroin, and my phone gets blown up that next morning at 6 a.m., 6:15, with text messages and phone calls that he didn't wake up, that he had overdosed and died. And so at this point, I'm just like, I'm done. All of these things God used to put me in a position where I was sensitive to hearing his voice. And in September 2010, I went to Portland Teen Challenge. My third day there, this mountain lady came up to me and said, I feel like God told me to come over here and tell you something. And I remember she closed her eyes and said, you should be dead. God loves you so, so much. And that night I went to that Portland chapel. I remember before I went in, I just praying, God, I need to know that you're with me in this situation. You know what's going on. You know my circumstances. I don't want to hear some vacation Bible school story I've heard my whole life, but I need to know that you're in this with me. And no lie, no joke, the guest pastor who came in that Portland chapel slammed his Bible down and said, I'm not going to tell you some vacation Bible school story you've heard your whole life, but I'm going to talk to you about surrendering your life to the will of God and scrapping any plans that you had for your life and giving everything to him. And at 8:36 p.m., September 8th, 2010, I rededicated my life to Christ, and I haven't been the same since. From that decision, I knew that God was calling me to go to TCMI. I got a huge heart and passion for youth ministry. It was there at TCMI, working with the youth ministry there, where I was like, man, I want these students to be more blessed than I could ever be. I want them to do greater things than I can ever do, and I don't want them to make the same mistakes that I've made. And so it was there that I knew that God was calling me to be a youth pastor. Now I currently am a youth pastor at the Oasis of Hollywood. I've been there coming up on 3 years, and I give a huge, huge like credit and shout out to TCMI, because that's where I got a foundation in ministry, a foundation just being disciplined and what it looks like to read your word and to have a devotion time. It was there that really served as the foundation blocks for where I'm at today.